two things will either happen towards menopause or the perimenopause. They'll skip their periods, which means that month they didn't even have enough estrogen, nor did they have the progesterone. So that can signal actual menopause, because you need at least estrogen to have bleeding and the progesterone to finish the cycle off to post-ovulation to encourage an egg or a pregnancy. And when that doesn't occur, and most women in the menopause or perimenopause don't want to have a pregnancy. So it's not as big of an issue when it comes to fertility at that age group after 42, 45. This is a whole new era in women's health, because women are pushing back their childbearing years to the late 30s and sometimes 40s to mid 40s. And they need the whole cycle. They need the ovulation, and they need everything, including the progesterone. And when that starts to dwindle, they run into the perimenopause time and the lack of ovulation, the lack of pregnancy. So their risk for getting pregnant or their chance of getting pregnant is so low. If we're not dealing with fertility, we are concerned about the irregular periods. And we can supplement them with some estrogen. There's natural estrogens and the man-made estrogens, of course. And I think most women use man-made estrogens now, but sometimes in certain circles that there is a difference or a change, that some women talk about it to each other and they go to a center that gives them pellets or creams or shots or whatever to keep their cycles regular. But they also feel that there's a balance there, that they don't have that emotional swing, you know, so they feel so much better.